Hello, my name is Hardevinder. Today we are going to solve a question paper that is Cambridge International Examination, Cambridge International General Certificate of Secondary Education, October-November 2018, Data Analysis and Website Authring. In this session, we will solve only website authoring. Let us start. Task 1, evidence document. Open the file n183evidence.rtf. Let us open. Here we are having a source file. And here is this. We are going to solve this question paper using open source software. Means we are not going to use any licensed software. Operating system which we are going to use is Ubuntu, which is an open source software operating system. And word processor LibreOffice, which is also an open source software. And Notepad++, this is also open source software. So in this session, for solving this question paper, we are using all open source softwares. Means we don't need to buy any license for using these softwares. Free of cost we can use. So I'll open this file in LibreOffice word processor. This is n183 evidence rtf, open with LibreOffice writer. So this is a evidence file we are having. Let us start the question. Open the file n183evidence.rtf, which we have already opened. Make sure your center number, name, and candidate number will appear on every page of your evidence document by placing these details in the header. Save this as a word processed document in your work area with the file name n183evidence followed by your candidate number, for example n183evidence 9999, which is a dummy candidate number. You will need to place screenshot and answers to questions in the evidence document. Yes guys, they have not mentioned which word processor you will have to use. So in this case, we can use any word processor. Microsoft Word, LibreOffice, OpenOffice, Google Document, any word processor we can use. There is no foundation to use that particular word processor only. So I am using a LibreOffice because this is open source and free of cost, license free software. So firstly, I have already opened. Make sure your name, center number, and the candidate number will appear on every page of your evidence document, placing these details in header. So in this, you can go to insert, header and footer, then header, default style. Firstly, we'll have to write your name. Hardevinder Singh. Center number, Oh, center number is GPSMGG. And candidate number is 001. Save this as processed document in your work area with the file name 183 evidence followed by a candidate number. File save as, this is already written, followed by your candidate number 001. This document may contain formatting content that cannot be saved in a currently selected file name rich.txt. Use as an ODF file format to be sure that the document is saved correctly. Use ODF format means this is a Word format. Now we are not going to use with the extension .rtf. Now we are going to use .odf. So using this, you can save it. Now let us start. Task 2, web page. We will develop a web page for the construction department of Sheila's steel sheds. Efficient markup and style sheet must be used. All color code must be in hexadecimal. Create a new folder called sheds. Locate the following file and store them in your sheds folder. n183construct.png, n183tablestyle.css, sslogo.jpg. We'll have to create a new folder, sheds. Right click, new folder, sheds. Locate the following files and store them in your sheds folder. n183construct.png, n183tablestyle.css, sslogo.jpg. So let us start. This is already open. Here is n183 shed.csv, n183 table style, and this n183construct.png. These files we need to copy. Control C, copy. Open this folder and paste. Control V, paste all these files in this folder. Yes, construct triple S. By mistake, these has been saved without the folder. So we will delete them because all the files we need to locate in sheds folder. So we have all saved in sheds folder. Let's move further. The table styles required by the company are all internal and external grid lines, for the table must be single border 4 pixel wide, which can be seen on the web page. The grid lines should be defined as triple grid lines, color components in hexadecimals, blue, green, red. External lines blue color 0, green color 0, and red color full red. Internal lines blue 33, green 57, and red double F. All tests should be center aligned with the table, both horizontal and vertical. John, a trainee, has created a style sheet N183 tablestyle.css for these table styles. Examine the style sheet and evaluate in your own words the syntax and efficiency of the style sheet. So let us see this file N183 tablestyle.css, which has been created by John. Let me check. It's in shares folder. Here is the shares folder, and this we can open it with Notepad++. This is a file created by John. External style sheet. Table TD background color. All zeros. Border width 4 pixel. Border style solid. Border collapse, text align center, vertical align center, border color, and TD color. Guys, for checking the color codes, we can use any photo editor. I'm going to use GIMP. GIMP is a good photo editor, open source software. For solving all the questions, we are using open source softwares, which are no need to buy any license for using these all softwares. So what they are required? They required external lines. External lines means table border, and internal lines means TD, internal columns of a table. So external lines means table border, we need full in red. So let us see, is it, this is a table and the border color is this. So let me check in GIMP. Guys, if we need full red, guys, as you will see, this is a RGB, red, green, and blue. So for format of writing is RGB. They required R, full red means double F, 0 green and 0 blue. Every color contains 2 characters, means we need 6 characters, 2 zeros for green, 2 zeros for blue, and double F, that is a full red. For red, the sequence in which we will write that till RGB, red, green, blue. Here, John has written 00000F. So, I think he has written in the format of BGR. This is not a correct format. The correct format is RGB. So for red, we are writing double F, full red. For green, 00. And for blue, 00. Every color contains two characters. One more mistake John has done, that in hexadecimal color code we need to write hash. So here is double F 00 and 00. Double F for red, 00 RGB, G green, and again 00 for blue. So this we can mention in evidence also, as they have asked. John, a trainee, has created this of these table styles. Examine the style sheet and evaluate in your own words the syntax and efficiency of the style sheet. This is in evidence 1. Type your evaluation in your own words into your evidence document using no more than 100 words. Guys, here we write, the first point is, the color code should be RGB instead of BGR. Color code for external border. Yes, external border should be FF0000 instead of 0000FF. 00FF means red, 00 green, and again 00 blue. So the format is RGB. This is the first correction which we have done in this style sheet. As they have told, examine the style sheet. Examine means you will have to examine. Is that correct or wrong? If there is any mistake, we'll have to correct that, and we'll have to write the same in our evidence document. But there is a condition, we cannot exceed our answer more than 100 words. Within that limit, we'll have to completely correct that style sheet and write the evaluation of our what is observation about that CSS style sheet. So let us see more. What more mistakes? We say all the colors should be in hexadecimal. All the text should be centralized and the table both horizontal and vertical. All internal and external guidelines of the table must be single border 4 pixel wide, which can be seen on a web page. The grid line should be defined as. Firstly, we'll have to write all in hexadecimal. See, background color. If we will do all colors are GB 00000, but it will completely be a dark black. All colors are 00, so background of the table will be black. Hash was not written in place of colors. In the beginning of the color hash, and then 2 multiplied by 3, 8 characters should be there for writing a code in hexadecimal. So here also we need to correct hash, then 4 plus 4 plus 4, 6, sorry, 6 characters we need. There are 3 code color combination, RGB. The same we can write in evidence document in the second point. Hexadecimal code of color must be started with hash. Sometimes the people say hashtag also. Let's see more. Border width 4 pixel, as they have told, border style sold solid, border collapse, but that's not mentioned in the question, but John has mentioned collapse. It is okay, no problem. Test should be aligned center, it's okay. Vertically aligned center, not vertical align. Will be not a vertical align. Let me check. Yes guys, they have mentioned that vertical align should be center. The word center we can use in horizontal align. For the vertical alignment we can use the word middle instead of center, right? Middle. One more thing which we have to notice, all attributes, and after writing their properties, when the statement is completed, we are inserting semicolons at the end. But in the last attribute of a particular tag selector, it's optional. We can write a semicolon or not. It's optional in the last. Here it's only a single, so it's no required. Here also it's a single, no required. But here it's in the last, so this is not a mistake. So we have changed vertical line should be middle. So let us change that. Vertical line should be middle. Let us check. Type valuation in your own words into your evidence document using no more than 100 words. Chauhan is a trainee. Examine the style sheet and evaluate in your own words the syntax and efficiency of the style sheet. Syntax we have already corrected what were the mistakes. So one more thing, efficiency we can notice that table and TD, two selectors has been used in this collectively instead of different. It controls the redundancy. We don't need to write the codes different for table and TD. Collectively we have written table comma TD. This is the efficiency of this style sheet. Same we'll have to write in our evidence document. Efficiency is TD table properties have been set collectively. This controls the redundancy of code. One more thing which we can notice here is that the background color of the table is black. 0000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000 What will be the foreground color? That has not been mentioned here. So by default the foreground color is black. If background is black and foreground is black, then it will not be visible. So the font color should be white, black and white. This is not mentioned in this question paper, which should be a background color. But so we'll have to think proactively. If background color is black, how can we see the text on the screen? So we'll write here font color. Sorry, not a font color, it will be only a color, that is white. See, we have inserted a semicolon after, because now this is not a last property of this selector. Here we don't need to put, instead of white, we can write the code in hexadecimal. As earlier we have read in this question paper, all the color codes should be in a hexadecimal. So we have to see the hexadecimal code for the white color. This is a white color, completely white. This code we can use for white color, this corner. Completely white, this combination, or we can use this color picker also. So this is a white color, all FFFF, full white. For full black, we use all zeros, but for full white, we can use all Fs, FFFF and FF. How we have selected this, you can use this color picker, click here, and this is a white color, it has automatically been selected, all else. And instead of writing white, we will use a hexadecimal code. This also we can mention color combination should be contrast with background and foreground. Foreground color is white, color has been set white, and color code of background is already black. So quiz evidence already has increased 103 words. They have told we have to complete in within 100 words, no more than 100 words. 3 words already has increased, so don't worry, it's okay. 2 or 3 words you can exceed, not more than that. But our evidence is complete. This is of 4 marks. Let's move further. Added the trainee style sheet so that it matches the table style required by the company. add CSS to your style sheet. 2. Automatically place all tables in the center of the window. Set the style h1 to white font. Add your name, center number and candidate number to the end of the style sheet as a comment. Save a style sheet as a table followed by your candidate number, for example table 4x9.css. Take a copy of your screen style sheet and place this in your evidence document, evidence 2. This is of 7 marks. So guys, very important question, 7 marks. You will have to add some features in CSS. So what we need to add? Edit the training style sheet so that it matches the table style requested by the company. Edit and add. Add CSS to your style sheet to automatically paste the table in the center of the window. This is automatically place the table in center of window. So how to do? Just we'll take a pause. So guys, automatically place all tables in the center of the window means left and top alignment, left and right alignment, margins. We can write auto, or you can mention left margin left auto or margin right auto, or simply margin auto. It will apply on both sides, left and right. So here semicolon margin auto. It will automatically align our table in the center. Set the style h1 to a white font. H1 to a white font. Have to write one more selector, that is h1 color. As for color, you can write simply a color, not text color, font color or anything, simply a color, that means foreground color. This is a white color code. You can copy this one and paste here. Yes. Add your name, center number and candidate number to the end of style sheet as a comment. Comment, you can write a comment in CSS in this way, backslash star. The comment means what you will write in this comment, it will not be considered as a part of CSS commands. The document, your name Hardevinder Singh, simply name Hardevinder Singh, center number GPS MGG. Then candidate number, that is 0001. Closing a comment, you can write star and forward slash. Save your style sheet as a table followed by your candidate number. For example, table 9999.css. File, save as table. Table followed by your center number. sorry, candidate number. File has been saved. Take a copy of your style sheet and place in your evidence document. You don't need to take a screenshot. We can just copy the code and paste in evidence 2 here. Okay, let's move further. This 7 marks content we have completed. Identify the name of correct web development layer to complete each of the following statements. Guys, you must be knowing there are 3 layers in web development: presentation layer, development layer, and yes guys, there are 3 layers: structure layer, style layer, and behavior layer. In the structure layer, we will write HTML code, and in style layer, CSS, and behavior layer, JavaScript. Let us see. The cascading style sheets are part of the dash layer in website development. That is a second layer, style layer. Hyperlinks are an action in web page and they are part of the layer. Hyperlinks we do in HTML. This is a structure layer. The text and images of a web page are added to the web page in a dash layer. That is also a structure layer, HTML. An action like hover over or on click, you would be found in the dash layer. These things we can do in JavaScript, and JavaScript is a behavior layer. These 4 questions: type the name of each web development layer into your evidence document. Let us type. First is cascading style sheets are part of the style layer. And the second question: hyperlinks are an actions in web page and they are part of dash layer, structure layer. And the text and images of a web page are added into the web page in the same again structure layer. And the last is an action like hover over, on click, would be found in the dash layer. These are part of JavaScript and this is behavior layer. This question has been completed. Now go further. Now create a web page called sheds.htm. This web page must work in all web browsers and will have table structure as shown below. Each table cell is identified with the letter and all dimensions are in pixels. The letter and dimensions shown in the table must not appear on your final web page. So guys, let us take a pause. Guys, these are the rules: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 rows and 2 columns. Here 2 columns are merged and here 4 rows are merged, and here again 2 columns are merged. So we will focus on all these things. This is a width of a table, this is a height of a row, sorry, a width and height of the row. Guys, width and height we can mention in structure layer HTML also, but it's better if we will do all these things in a CSS. Internal or external? We have already external style sheet. I think we forgot to attach. Yes, we will have to attach that with our web page also. So let us create a page. In a notepad, we can create it. New file, save as. The name of the web page should be shares.htm. Height and width of the columns we can write in internal style sheet or external style sheet. I'll prefer external style sheet. We have already this external style sheet. We can add in this. For different columns we can create different IDs, and for particular column in structure layer we can use that ID, and all the properties which we have mentioned in CSS will be applied accordingly that ID. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 columns. So 7 columns means 7 IDs we can create. So first, for creating ID, I need to write hash. The first ID is A, capital A or small a, that is capital A. Doesn't matter, you can use any letter. Sorry, this is a A. Hash A. Height of this is 810 by 130. 810. And width is 130. Sorry, this is a width. And this is a height. That is pixels. Height and width are in pixels. So width is, height is 130. 130 pixels. So guys, for instead of writing code again and again, we can copy and paste. B, 600 by 600. B. C, D, E, and F. All columns have same width and same height. So we will use redundancy control in CSS. Instead of writing different codes for different columns, we can reduce our code. We can write all IDs by commas, separate C, D, E, and F. So here paste. C, H, D, H, E, and F. C, D, E, and F. 210, 150. Now the last one is G. G. That is 810 by 80. Width. Width 810. This. And height 50. Fix. So we can save it. Write sheds.html. Firstly, we start HTML. Add title. They have not mentioned in the question what will be the title, and we can just write title as a sheds. Then we need to link that style sheet. Link. Then rel equal to style sheet href equal to table.1.css. So guys, here we have linked our external style sheet with our HTML table. And close the head. We start body, then table, then first row. So guys, this is our first row. It is a merge of two columns and ID is A. PR PD. ID equal to A and call span 2 TD close, and this row is close. So this row has been completed. The second row, this is merge of four rows. The row span we can use here, row span, second row here, in the first PD equal to B, row span 4 and TD close, again TD, sorry, here is ID. First is ID C, TD close, we can copy it, Control C copy, shortcut for Control C copy, then paste. Is a capital C, capital D, capital E, capital F, this row I think is completed. So guys, this row is completed. Now the last row, G. The last row, TR. TD, ID equal to G. TD close and row close. Total close. Body close and HTML close. Save it. So guys, let me check how's our web page look like. Is it according to that? 8. Sheds. Where is that? Sheds.html. Open with Firefox. There's something is wrong here. It's not according. Let us check what's the mistake. TR TD 8 call span not 2. Okay, then TR row span 4. TD close 4 TDs. TR close, TD ID equal to G, TD TR close. What's wrong in this table? 1, 2 columns. These are the rows, not columns. Let us check. So guys, these are rows. You have to close row. Close a row here. Again, start row. And close row. Start row. Close row. Start. Start and it's already closed. See, so let us check. Now it's open. 1, 2, 3, 4 column picker. That is F. What's wrong with this column? TD row span 4, TD close, TR C equals D E F, and this is G. Why this is F? I think something wrong with here. C D E F all okay. C D E F all closed. Here we have to merge two columns. All span equal to 2. Last column we need to merge two columns. F5. Now it's okay. Two rows we have made. This 1, 2, 3, 4. The last here two rows. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is extra column. So how to remove? Let me check. So guys, this is okay. This page is ready. What was the mistake? Here will be a row span 5 instead of row span 4. This is first row, second, third, fourth, and this is fifth. This is should be a row span 5 instead of row span 4. After that, it's okay. Now save it. It's already saved. Next, move further. Each table cell identified the letter and all dimensions are in the pixels and letters or dimensions shown in the table must not appear in the final bit page. Guys, mentioned it's not showing in the final web page. Internal lines are blue, but external lines are not red. The reason behind it is external lines have been replaced by the internal lines. When we are creating, we have mentioned TD. All TDs blue. So this blue color covered that black external lines, red external lines. See, you can see the corners. These are the red. So that's why. So don't worry. And move further this question. The image triples logo.jpg has been created but has a white corner. Edit the image to remove these corners. Save the image with the new format triples logo.png. Place in cell A image triples logo.png. So guys, firstly we can just test. We can insert image triples logo.jpg. What's wrong in that image? Let me check. Triples logo.jpg. Copy. So we'll have to insert this image here. Write a code. Image source.jpg. Close. Alternate. No image. So save it. File. So guys, as they have mentioned in the question, these corners are white. .jpg file. We'll have to remove these white corners and we need to save the same photo in the format of .png. PNG means transparent background. We can edit this photo in GIMP, GNU Image Manipulation Program, open source photo editing software. Guys, let us. This is a triple S logo.jpg. We need to edit. Open with image viewer. Open with other application. GNU image manipulation program. Select it. This is already opened. Convert. Okay. So, guys, we can select this image with round corners and copy it, and we can save it in a transparent background. So how to do? You can use this rectangle tool for selection. Radius means already radius. You can just see radius. It's already corners are radius. And reduce them a little bit. Just check. Okay. What is the height and width of this image? image, image properties, the size 800 by 120 pixels. 800 by 120 pixels. So select it. Measure here 800 by 120. So set the positions. Position 0 and 0. So 0 positions means it has covered all the boundaries from beginning to the end, top and left. This pixels. Now what we need to do, we can copy this. Control C, copy, open file new, 800 by 120, advanced options. So instead of background color, we need transparency. These white corner should not display there. So okay, white, this shows is a transparent background. Paste it. Sorry, paste. You need to copy it again. Copy, paste. Okay guys, now save it. File, export as PNG, it's already PNG. So the name SSS logo dot PNG. SSS logo dot PNG. Export. Where to export? Our desktop shells here. Export. So image already been saved. What is shells? This is replace logo.png. The JPG, change it to PNG. Let us check. This is another image. Earlier it was replace logo.jpg, which is already in that folder. We have saved another image, that is replace logo.png. So let us check, is it okay now? F5. Yes guys, corners have been removed, white corners. So let's move further. Place in cell B the image N183 construct dot PNG. This image, and resize the image in your markup so that it is 600 pixels square. Wise markup means you can do these height and width in structure layer. We have to do, we have mentioned in your markup. So in structure layer means in HTML you can mention, no need to do in CSS. All right, it's in B corner. Click here, image src. Height 600 square, width 600, and ALT no image. I save it. Let us check. F5. So this is okay. Image has been saved. Yeah. Move further. place a test specialized sheet shed in cell C, aluminium sheds in cell D, gallery in cell E, about us in cell F, web page created by, followed by your name, center number and candidate number in cell G. Set all these tests as style H1. So guys, in H1 already we have mentioned the color white. So earlier we were confusing that how the background color black and foreground color black. So we need to mention all the codes in H1. In H1 we have already mentioned the color white, so this is not required here. Save it. In our evidence document we can also delete this correction. So guys, in this way our word limit also been decreased to 63 words. Now we are in the limit of 100 words. So let us, the code is special steel sheds in cell C, H1. Let us see this. H1 close. Well, we can copy this. Make our work fast. So here is H1, C, D, E and F and G. All now we need to write a test here. In D we need to write aluminium sheds. In D, aluminium sheds is a D column. Aluminium sheds. In E, gallery. We need to write here gallery. In F, about us. About us. Web page created by, followed by your name, center number and candidate number in cell G. Hardevinder Singh, GPS MGG 0001. Set all the test as H1. We have already set the style sheet that you saved in step 2 to your web page, which we have already attached in previous. Save the web page in your sheds folder. This is saved. Display the web page in your browser if necessary. Resize so that all the web pages can be seen. All the text can be easily read. The address bar is visible. Take a single screenshot of the browser window and displace it in your evidence document, evidence 4. Guys, let us check first. That is F5. Specialized steel sheds, aluminium sheds, gallery, about us, web page created by Hardevinder Singh, GPS MGG01. It's already fit. So no need to do any editing in this. And we need to take a screenshot of that. Let's take a pause. So guys, we need to take a single screenshot of your browser window and place in this in your evidence document. Screen. This is a screenshot. Need to take a screenshot of this. Take a screenshot. Sorry, in the recording. Screenshot. Grab the whole screen, grab the current window, screen area to grab. You can take screen area to grab. So this area we can select. It's not showing the whole. Can it zoom in? Yes, it's okay. So okay, now screenshot. Grab the whole screen, it's okay. Include pointers. No need to grab after delay of 0 seconds. Okay. Take a screenshot. Give the name. The name they have told. Place a single screenshot. You will have to place in evidence document, so any name you can save it and save it in pictures, save in folder pictures, screenshot from shares, screenshots, shot, save. So let me check in picture folder and picture shared screenshot. Guys, we don't require this bar, so we need to take a screenshot again. Screen. Let us check screenshot of sets. Now it's okay. So we need to place the single screenshot browser window in the evidence document, evidence 4. So here is evidence 4. Go to insert. Here will be an insert picture image. Picture screenshot that was a screenshot of shares. This one open. Now, what we need to do is evidence 5, take a copy of HTML source and place in your evidence document. HTML source. This is our HTML source. We can take the screenshot of this. It will be better. Otherwise, you can copy also. Copy. Then paste it. I think this is okay. And we need to save it. So guys, this question has been solved. Thanks for watching. Please leave the comment how this video was. Thanks for watching. Thank you very much. Bye bye.